Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. Friends, today we're going to learn a concept which is known as the total expense ratio formula. We'll be learning not only the formula, but at the same time the explanation part, the use, and we'll be also calculating one real life example so that, you know, we have a complete hold on the formula. Now here on the screen, what you can see, the total expense ratio formula, it shows the total fund costs divided by the total fund assets. So the cost divided by the assets is all we can see right now at the very point of time. Let's understand this in a complete detailed manner. The total expense ratio, which is also known as your TER ratio, it is also known as your TER formula, is used for investment funds. Now, TER formula is very useful for investors because it shows how much they have actually earned. Very important. And no, it's not enough to know the return on the, you can say, the investment. It's also important to know the total expense ratio at the very same time. So the total expense ratio's formula goes something like this, is equal to your total fund cost divided by your total fund assets. So this is going to be your formula for your total expense ratio. Let's understand this formula with the help of a real life example. Let's say there's a company called KG Investments, and they have been managing a few new funds, and it has given with some following information, like the total fund cost, which is standing at, let's say, $40,000, and they have the details of total fund assets, which is standing at, let's say, $410,000. Right, so this is your total fund assets and this is your total fund cost. So we know that both the total fund cost and the total fund assets. So by using the TER formula, we get something like this, is equal to 40,000. That is the total fund cost divided by total fund assets. That is your 9.76 is the answer. Now the investor need to see the total expense ratio of the new fund, and then compare the same with other investments to see whether this is a worthy investment for the investor or not. Now, this is the example of, as you can see from the table, this is the TER, that is the total expense ratio of Vanguard firms, which ranges from 0.11 to 0.16, because the higher side is 0.16. Lower side is 0.11 and the mid part you can say 0.15. So this is the expense ratio of Vanguard funds. See, the federal money market has an expense ratio of 0.1. If you can see, it is standing at 0.11, and whereas the California municipal money market is standing at 0.16. And for the prime money market is 0.16, and the municipal money market stands at 0.15. So as you can see, this is the real life example of Vanguard funds, which has different money market funds and the expense ratio. Let's understand the explanation part of this particular formula. See, understanding the TER is really important. It has two components. The first component is the total fund cost. Is the total fund cost. Now the total fund cost mainly includes the management fee, along with the total fund cost also including, you know, legal fees like trading fees. So I'll just write legal, then you have trading fees, then you have any operating expenses and auditing fees. The second component in our formula of the TER is the total fund assets. Now the total fund asset, in the case of any investment funds, you can say that a group of people manages the funds, and these funds are the assets of the individuals who have invested into the instruments. And the instruments that I'm talking about here is the mutual funds, and these funds, you can say that are called the, these funds are known as the fund assets. So in simple terms, fund assets are the market value of the funds that have been managed by a fund manager or a team of a manage of a team of a management. So when we compare the fund expenses, so what do you need to compare? The fund expenses, and the second thing is the fund assets. We get the proportion of the expense in terms of the assets. So this TER can be used to find out how much expenses that has actually happened, right? So this was the explanation part. Now we need to dig into the use, the significance. So basically, where exactly is the use of the TER formula? The main reason for which the TER is important to the investor is that the TER directly affects the return on their investments, right? First, this is the first point. Second, now over here in the first, I'll take an example. Let's say there's a guy called, again, Mr. KG, and he has invested into a portfolio. He's expecting a return of, let's say, 10% on his investments. Now, if he can find out the TER, he'll be able to figure out the actual return on the investments. So let's say the TER is standing at 4% over here. Then the net return would be actually 6%. And if it seems that he is getting a return of 10% on his investments. So TER formula is like, you know, more when the funds is actively managed. Because when the funds are actively managed, the operational expenses of the funds gets increased. This gets increased. Like, for example, if a fund is actively handled, then the personal costs will likely to go up. So actively managing a fund may also ensure a higher return and you can say a quick reaction time, right? So on the other hand, if the funds is not actively managed, then in that scenario, the TER is going to be less and the return may actually dry up. It may go down. So, however, these are always in exceptions. Now we're going to take some numbers over here. We're going to punch in some numbers: the total fund cost, the total fund assets, and the total expense ratio. Let's put down some numbers. I'm writing 2014, 15, this is 16, this is 17, and this is 2018. We are going to punch down some numbers. Let's say the cost is 40,000, and every year there is an increase of the cost by, let's say, $1,000. Control R. The total fund assets is increasing. So here we'll say that, you know, there is an increase by 1 plus, let's say, 10%. Let's go for the 10% increase. Control R. So every year there's a 10% increase in the cost. So the total fund assets, let's say, is standing at $100,000. And here there will be an increase of, let's say, 1 plus 5%. So we'll try and incorporate those numbers. Now try and calculate the ratio. So your assets are increasing at 5%. Your total fund cost is increasing at 10%. So your ratio will be somewhere close to 40, 42, 44, 46, and 48. So there is a stiff increase by 2% every year. You can put down your own numbers and really come out with some really good conclusions. Thank you, everyone.